Love Talk Radio.
Welcome to Body and Soul Awareness with Stephanie and Oxana. Here are your hosts. Hello, everyone. This is Oxana and Stephanie. How are you? Stephanie actually will not be checking in and potentially maybe later with us, but today we have an amazing show ready for us to discuss. We have a great guest coming in that I'll chat about shortly. But speaking of last week's homework, first I would like to kind of remind everyone what we talked about last week and our homework. So the conversation was about transition and going through changes through in life and what tools we can use to make it a little bit easier, health-wise and, you know, mindset and clarity in your path. And what we ask, I guess, to do is to look back at the last time you went through your transition and see how you were, you know, how did you, what decisions you made, what your thoughts were, how did you approach the situation, what did you do anything related to health, enhancement, and to utilize our tools that we've discussed that this time, you know, if you're going through change this time, what, how do you see the situation now, and do you see yourself going through it mentally differently and physically differently, energetically differently? So, and we presented so many tools in regards to health and, you know, classes that I teach and energy and yoga and massages and sauna. Then we also addressed meditation. And I hope, you know, some of you did do that. In regard to me and my homework, I ended up actually yesterday taking full day to myself. And I went to Karine's spa, close by here, about 40 minutes away. And it actually reminds me of saunas that we have in Russia as well. So I, you know, when I started going to Karine's spa here, first I only saw, you know, Asians and Russians. Now I see everyone there. I'm like, oh, too much. And the only thing that's kind of starting to bother me about that place is cell phones. Cell phones in those stone rooms, usually it does happen with younger generation, but I'm like, people, you're here to relax, enjoy yourself, detox, sweat, not think about what is going on your phone or your computer, and you bring that into that space. That, yeah, I did not like that, but it's okay. I zoomed in, zoomed out, and I went into my space, and I enjoyed myself. I did a foot massage, which I highly recommend because we have so many points on our feet that address our meridian channels and the energy that our body consists in. So I highly recommend that. I mean, of course, any massage is awesome. But the feet massage definitely will be a big contribution to relaxation and well-being. So I did do homework. I was a good girl. And And I hope you did too, because it's so important. We run through life, we do things, including me. I have a lot on my list, and to find time to, you know, be okay and relax into yourself and breathe deep, you know, just like I'm doing now, one step at a time. And it's funny because I've had a few conversations with some of my friends these past couple of weeks in regards to that, you know, how they have so much going on and absolutely have no time to dedicate to themselves, you know, to go to a massage, to do a hot tub, you know, to relax in the evening with bubble bath, or to just sit in quiet, you know. Some people don't even have that luxury because they either have kids or they live with people, you know. So it can be challenging. And in those situations, I think it's good to expand, like we've talked about last week, expand and have a different view about it, and also know that this potential is just this period of life. You know, right now you are busy. Right now you created this. You have a lot of things going on. In fact, that's what I even tell myself. It's nobody's fault that I have all these things that I have to accomplish now. It's me. I've created it, you know. But I'm slowly kind of, you know, starting to minimize my life, hopefully. But in this situation, yeah, know that it's only temporarily, and if it's at your will, if it's at your wish, you will change it, and you will have less things to do if that's what you desire. And also what helps is to, if you don't have time to do something to your to benefit your health physically, start working on your mind, you know. Potentially you can look at life as present life, present situation in your life as this is my choice. So you have to accept the choice that you've made, even if you're busy. You have to find, you know, peace with that. Because if you will be pushing that aside, you know, you're thinking, I want to be doing this, but I'm doing this, it's the mental fight. So if you find peace with the thing that you're doing right now in your mind, then you will relax more than when you are doing it and thinking of some other thing that you need to be doing. So concentrate on what you're doing now, and that's where you will find that relaxation, that satisfaction maybe even, the peace you're looking for. And then next step you make, you know, you take it, you know, step back and see, do you want to do something else next time or continue like that in your mind? And does it help you throughout the day if you start thinking, okay, I find peace with the thing I'm doing right now, even though I want to be doing something else? So kind of like that. So you can work on your mind if you don't have time to work on physically on your either, you know, food or exercise or bath or anything, you know. Go into yourself internally. So that's kind of, you know, the homework. But also just briefly to catch up on the week that passed, we typically talk about this since Stephanie's actually at the airport, and she was going to take off today. But speaking of life and speaking of constant change, her plane was delayed. I don't know why, and she is on her way back. So she may join us a little bit later in the show, or she may not. Whichever happens, we are going with the flow. But if she does, then she can contribute, speaking of her week and how it went. But my week was, let's just say I was very happy when Friday came. Very, actually, when Saturday morning came. I had a very busy week. And it's been a little bit challenging, yes, and that's why I decided that I need to go to a spa, to a Korean spa, and do detox in stone rooms that detox all the yuckiness that we have inside, and also the foot massage, which really contributed to for relaxation. So I think I've And that's kind of the point. When we go through, time when we're busy and a little bit more stressed than regular, or stress versus no stress, you have to understand that you need to give back to yourself. You give out, give out, give out. You run, run, run. But you need to replenish yourself. So you have to be balanced overall in your life. So if you go crazy 1 week and you feel it strongly in your body, like I did, and for me, it's actually, it hits me even more because I don't go into places that don't feel anymore that great. It just doesn't happen for me, but once in a while it does. So when you recognize you've gone too far, contribute to yourself with giving in, giving back. So go to the spa, do the massage, do the yoga class, do the meditation, do the, just relaxation or hot tub or even mental work. So something you have to do because until you don't get to the place where you just uncomfortable like that. So, but that was my week. I'm glad it was over. It was intense and, pretty fast, but it was productive. A lot was accomplished, and I'm glad it's over, but next week is next week. It's going to be next interesting challenge, I guess, and observation. But what I wanted to talk about now is our guest, who actually is with me in the studio today. So I'm very, very happy. So the special guest is Dee Lopez. She is, let me just tell her, tell you about her a little bit, and then I'll tell you how I connected with her. So Dee is a single mom and the owner of Romes Pet Sitting Services at only 26 years of age. Before starting the business, she became a veterinary technician and worked 12-hour shifts at Animal Hospital as a vet tech. After becoming a mom, she decided to take another route and start her own company to have more time with her family. And using her skills as a veterinary technician, she helps her clients with special needs as well as pets' behavioral issues. She enjoys having her days in the outdoors, caring for her clients' pets, and being able to be a full-time pet sitter and mother all at once. So let's welcome Dee. We can chat a little bit more how I met her when we bring her on because I'm so excited to have her. Dee, could you please join us?
Hi. Thanks for having me.
Absolutely. I'm very excited because, as you know, I am very much in touch with energy and I, a lot of times view people as energy and how I feel about them, not just what they say because they can say whatever they want.
Exactly.
So, and when I stumble upon you and I was searching for my new cat sitter, I stumbled on you and right away we connected and I felt right with you and I was happy to bring you on board and let Charlie explore you a little bit more and you too exploring him.
Exactly.
both ways. So I was so happy to meet you like that and I'm excited to have you here because I think animals are so important in our lives. And I think there's a lot of people that do love animals, but also a lot of people that don't.
Exactly.
And, it's scary. To me, it's scary, but it is what it is, And that's why we're here. We want to talk about our lovely animals and how they are a huge benefit to our lives. And on top of that, we'll talk about, how we can care for them and be more connected to them. So could you tell us, more about yourself and how you found yourself here now doing what you're doing?
Well, what can I say? My wake-up call was becoming a mother at 21. And I would work 12-hour shifts, and pretty much my son didn't know who I was.
Yeah, yep. And that's a lot of people going through that right now. I mean, all the time. And I actually love that aspect about you because I have a number of friends who are also doing that, and I know personally, running my own business as well, starting. It takes so much time. I can't even imagine having a child as well. So so how did you do it? Like, what can you say? What was the initial challenges, I guess? And, you know, you can also say not just the practical that we have to go through, and that you can also speak of, because a lot of people need it to hear that, and which will help them to go through their stuff. But also mentally, like, what are the challenges and what are the benefits, of course? We can talk about benefits a little bit later, but, like, what were the challenges to transition from, you know, let's just say corporate established facility to your own practice?
Well, I did lots of research, just to let you know right off the bat.
Awesome.
Lots of research. And I went as far as meeting other people that had their own business, and I put myself in that state of mind where I have to be the boss, be able to know how to do invoices, all the practical stuff, you know. But I did lots and lots of research. And after doing all the research, I changed my state of mind.
Nice.
So it's a lot of work.
So it's a lot of mind work, like, you know.
Yeah. I'm not living paycheck to paycheck, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah, it's nice.
It's nice. But it's not easy. And it's not for everybody.
Mm-hmm. So your push was your child, right?
Yes. Exactly.
So everyone probably has that either push or something that happens internally, you know, like, for example, for me, it was, you know, because I do have the business. I mean, of course, it's a lot, but it's the fact that, yeah, you'll have to support yourself fully. You know, you're totally taking responsibility of your life. You are the boss. You have to get the clients, so that's a big, big step in your mind where, and fear.
Exactly.
You know,
a lot of fear. Yes. But I use that as a motivation.
Okay. Yeah. So see, you're using kind of the shadows of ego to benefit you.
Yes.
And that's exactly what I do too. Like, you know, that's what they say. If you're afraid of something, do it.
Exactly.
You know, and
exactly.
Then you want to be afraid of it. It's just a matter of not knowing, right? So, okay. So what were you, so what main challenges did you observe, I guess? Like, what can you share with us that potentially, like, maybe, you don't have to go personal fully, but, like, any situations that you recall kind of that really, you know, made you a little worried, or,
I mean, of course, money, you know, that aspect, but, like, what happened to your transition from living alone to going back to my parents' house?
Okay.
Yeah. That's a big step. Obviously, I didn't want to do that, but
yeah,
it had to be done. It had to be done.
Okay. Is that, like, the only...
No, it's not the only... Going out of my way to find people and my clients. That was maybe the hardest part, probably.
Mm-hmm.
Getting out there, going into strangers' homes, you know.
Hi.
Exactly.
Yeah. No, I see that. You have to have that kind of confidence, you know. That. And luckily, you already have that background because you've done the work.
Yes.
You're a veterinary technician. You actually know. And, I mean, that's what I liked also when I met you because, yeah, if anything, you have that.
Exactly.
You can. You don't necessarily have to, you know, take the path to the vet if something small happens. Very cool, very cool. So what do you see? How do you see your life changed? Like, what can you say, you know, you love about life, like, your life right now from last, you know, when you were with the corporate?
I have minimal stress. I don't have to deal with people. It's only me dealing with animals, pretty much.
Oh, my God. See, if Stephanie was right now on, she would so love this comment. She always says, I say the same thing a lot of times, too. Sometimes animals are so much better to be around than people.
Exactly.
People can drain you. Energies, you know, if you don't.
Well, animals are very neutral.
Yeah.
they're neutral. And if you're neutral, you just, you know, connect with them that way.
Yeah. Every time I come home and I pet Charlie, you know, if I had some sort of stress, it's gone.
Exactly.
Like 5-10 minutes and I'm, oh, I forgot about it.
Mm-hmm.
Everything is gone.
Exactly.
And we'll talk about, like, specific benefits a little bit later on the radio. But it's true. They are amazing. Like, I, you know, they require a little bit of work, of course, but it's so worth it.
And Charlie, I have 2 children, by the way. I bet. One is my dog and one is my actual son.
So tell us about your puppy.
Oh, he's not a puppy anymore. But
well,
he's puppy. I have a pit bull, and I had him before I had my son. So he's pretty much my first kid.
How old is he now?
He's turning 7.
7.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Awesome. The big fat baby. I love him to death.
Yeah, I know. I know how. I know what it is. And that's the thing, like, if you've never owned a pet, you don't, you kind of, you can fully relate, because when we say we love them, it's true. They are part of you. They're
exactly.
Here. They're, you know, and if they're not here, something is missing a little bit, you know? A little bit. I'm just being nice here.
A lot.
So, all right. So, okay, so you have, you don't have stress, minimal stress. So what other huge benefits do you see now?
I have a lot of free time to spend with my son and my family.
Mm-hmm.
A lot. Sometimes I have too much.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, magic. That's magic word. Really? Wow. We all should just start owning our pet service businesses. Come on, and live with parents. Well, I mean, remember what we were talking earlier?
Yeah.
Life has, it always... a progression, or it's always an evolvement somewhere. So
exactly.
you're never stuck in the same thing, unless you really want to be stuck, and you will be.
Exactly.
But everything serves its purpose, and you move through life, and sometimes you change, and I mean, life is change. It cannot be anything else. What any other benefits that we need to know and start businesses right away?
I get to see all these beautiful places every single day and connect with everybody's pets.
Mm-hmm. And because you are with pets all the time, that's why you don't have any stress.
Exactly. I guess it's cuddle with them sometimes. It's awesome.
Oh, my God.
You can't do that with, like, you know.
No, I know.
Humans. Like, oh, get away from me. No.
You're like, why? You're trying to be nice to me? Do you want something from me?
Exactly. Can't do that.
No. Well, you know, it's funny. When I went to Korean spa yesterday, I was so looking forward to it, and I was so happy. And I get there, and I had an appointment for the massage, and I'm asking the concierge. You know, I have an appointment for the massage at, I think it was 6:30, and he couldn't find it, and he started kind of giving me a hard time that I didn't. Maybe I didn't call or something in that matter. And I said, well, I mean, I probably should have gotten a confirmation number. But he really started to kind of be, you know, being irritable about it. So when I told him, I come here to relax, not stress.
Exactly.
I pretty much told him that in a very polite, normal manner. And it's true, because that's what I felt. You know, why are you being like this toward me when I'm in a spa? That's not good for your business. And, of course, he understood that with time, and, you know, it kind of worked. But exactly. It's like, why are you cuddling? Why do you want to cuddle with me? Why do you want to be nice to me? Like, well, because you don't want me to. I'm fine, you know. It's people complicate things. Animals don't.
No, they don't.
They
some
don't.
Of them. Some of them.
Well, my
Charlie.
Charlie is just a matter of knowing him. And he, in my eyes, he is a typical independent cat, in a sense. And I'm not surprised I picked him, because I am extremely independent.
I can see that.
Yes. And it's funny, because pets do kind of, you know, we choose similarities for some reason, however energetically.
Exactly.
But he's pretty much, you know, when I want you, please come here, and I'm going to now my butt off if you don't do this, and I'm going to get on your nerves and do all kinds of things. And, of course, you give in and you do it. The same happens when he doesn't want you. He will do everything possible to get you out of him and kick you away and show him his, you know, his character. So, but part of me, yes, he's like that, but part of me, I understand him, you know, okay, I want it, I don't want it. At least it's clear, kind of. And when you get to know him, you're fine with that. When
exactly.
you don't know him, then it's, you don't know how to be. So, and yes, and I mean, since the beginning, he's been extremely spoiled. He's never had other pets around him. He has lived with people, other people than me, before. But he's always been like that, independent. And even when he was tiny, he was independent and kind of...
That's just his personality.
It is. And I picked him. So it's all mine. But anyway, so let's go for to a quick break for now, for a couple of minutes, and we will be right back.
How would you like to make your work more enjoyable, be more creative and relaxed, all while sitting at your desk? That's exactly what my Serenity Rug has done for me. This revolutionary footrest, I can't even call it a footrest, because this thing encourages movement of your feet, which results in more blood flow. While traditional footrests advocate the motionless placement of your feet, I found that I'm unconsciously digging my feet into the long, soft grass strands of the Serenity Rug. It delivers an incredibly relaxing sensation that closely resembles the feeling of an exotic foot massage. If you have ever had a foot massage that made you want to stay there for hours, you know what I'm talking about. If you have not heard about the Serenity Rug, check them out at serenityrug.com and join the exclusive Serenity Rug community and enjoy a feeling of comfort and relaxation that most will never experience. They've sold out before, so I suggest you do your feet a favor and grab one of these. Again, that's serenityrug.com.
All right, we are back on air with Dee at Rome's Paws, and we are chatting about our lovely pets and how they contribute beautifully to our lives and how we can take a better care of them and enjoy the time with them and have a beautiful, happy life. Let's just put it that way. So, Dee, we left off at how your life transformed, how you see so many benefits running your own business, having your own schedule, clients, you know, how your life is less stressful. If you want to contribute more with benefits that you gain and you think will help our guests to, you know, inspire them on their path, please contribute and give us a little bit more if you want. Or let's just go into your service and let's talk about, you know, all the yummy stuff that happens when you connect with animals. Yeah?
Well, we can start off with energy.
Ah, lovely. Love that.
So pretty much when you meet a new dog or cat, if you're scared, you can't lie to them. You can put on a brave face, but they know it.
Yeah.
They know it. Happy thoughts equals happy vibes and positive energy.
Mm-hmm. So for example, how do you, like, you walk in and, like, what do you do? Like,
I change my energy. I pretty much trained myself to do that a very long time ago. So even if I feel stressed, I just, you know, pretty much meditate. Like right now in the elevator, I can meditate, and just by the time I get here, I have a neutral state.
No, that's good. That's very important. I mean, that's kind of what we do. You know, I do with classes as well, and throughout my life. And I'm amazed. I mean, I'm very happy to hear that. That's what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And I have worked with very, very aggressive dogs. Huge dog.
Oh my gosh.
And people, they're like, how do you do it? I'm like, I'm neutral. I can't think about what's stressing me out or if I'm scared or anything.
So what do you think from your observation and experience, what do you think they're sensing? I mean, that disharmony, like what is in the energy that they send? Because I've also experienced, for example, my cat, I mean, when he's just annoyed with something, it's one thing, but when he's scared, I've seen him.
Mm-hmm.
And it was people sometimes.
Exactly.
So what do you think that is presented there?
Animals sense how you feel or who you are. You don't even have to talk to them
mm-hmm.
at all. You make eye contact. Some of them don't like eye contact. So if I'm meeting a new dog or cat, I walk in, I don't make eye contact with them. I let them come to me, let them sniff me, let them get to know me, know my name,
yeah.
my
oh, yeah.
scent.
Oh, yeah.
And then during that time, I talk to the client. And I'm in a neutral state, and they're like, oh, they really like you. I'm like, yeah, I know. Exactly. But I've gone as far as helping out people with very aggressive animals that other people don't want to deal with.
Mm-hmm. So are you, do you know how to train them to become a little bit more?
It's not training them.
Training
the
people.
Exactly.
Oh,
exactly.
Nice.
So let's say somebody has a new pet and they sense that they're scared and whatnot, and it's the way that you are. They're going to pick up on that, and that's how they're going to be with you. You just have to train yourself to be, you know, neutral and happy, happy thoughts. Not all the time. Like, I know it gets stressful sometimes, but I pretty much, well, I push myself to be that way.
Well, in the beginning, it's the push kind of, but mm-hmm. then it becomes, you know,
natural.
First nature, yeah, you become that. That's what I talk about. First, yes, if you disbalance,
mm-hmm.
you have to kind of still work on it a little bit, and there are techniques. But when you are done with that, that's you.
Exactly.
You go through
exactly.
life like that. And that's when you become disbalanced, that only happens once in a blue moon, not the other way around.
Exactly.
And you get back into where you are, and that's just you.
Exactly.
Oh, well, that's, I very much agree with you that energy is so important. I know that too. And
can I just add that, well, I had to train myself to be that way because in the beginning, when I started, I was really scared. Like, I don't know what I'm doing. So I went as far as doing a lot of self-help, a lot, on my own. Even before starting the business, I was like, I have to be this person before I even start.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, it's the foundation that you want to have with anything, especially bringing, you know, with, of course, ideally with children,
mm-hmm.
ideally with animals, anyone you are surrounded with, you know, you want to have you
exactly.
figured out, hopefully,
yeah.
and
yeah.
balanced, you know.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
It takes a while, though. It does. It took me a couple of years to get there.
Oh, yes. It's almost even, you probably still kind of evolving,
mm-hmm.
too, you know, because we always change, but yeah. It does take time.
Yeah.
It's not just one overnight.
Yeah.
Wow, that's awesome. What else can you say about, like, the challenges sometimes that you've had and how you approached it with kind of animals that being surrounded around people that are of the not the equal, the balanced energy, I guess?
Well, pretty much. Rehabilitation. That's what I call it. So pretty much, let's say I get a new client and they have an aggressive dog. I go in there on my own and I go in, you know, to get to know them, they get to know me, they feel comfortable with me. The way that you interact with them and the way that they get to know you is by you going on walks with them.
Mm.
And not only having control of the situation at all times.
Well, hey, go with the flow. Life,
exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Life is a constant change. You can't expect everything.
Yeah.
Cool. So I also know that animals can assist with a lot of kind of even health issues.
Yeah.
And, you know, of course, stress relief. Everyone probably is aware of that.
Yeah.
But what other things that you know that they actually do help with if you have a pet? And
well, Pets can be good for you if you have heart problems. Because they get you to exercise.
Yeah, with walks.
Well, obviously with dogs. They need at least 3 times a day walks, and that's why people hire me, because they need that second walk during the day.
Yeah, you get that exercise.
Yeah, and it also heart attack survivors and people with abnormal heart rhythms, if they own dogs, they live longer.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I believe that for sure. Well, because stress is such a huge, you know, contribute, and I think it's related to probably a heart issue and immune system.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly. But that's pretty much how it is. I call my dog a stress reliever, and also he's like therapy to me. I could like cuddle with him, and I feel so much better.
Yeah. People just need to get a dog or cat and forget about the doctor.
Well, not really, but.
They could get there eventually. Well, but I mean, if you prevent health issues with stress relief, like animals, you don't need to go to the doctor. I mean, hopefully you won't have an issue.
Well, you can, you know, cancel your dates with your therapist.
Here we go. That too. Well, you know, they say nowadays, get a dog so you can meet somebody on the street while you're walking. Here we go. You don't have to get on those online. Sorry, I don't believe in this online dating situations, but it's okay. I know it happens, and I know it works for some people. But, get out of that and go outside, play with animals and on the grass, and get a date.
All in one. It's a great day.
I know. So, okay, so what else can they contribute? Like, I mean, like, why do you have a pet? Like, what? Because that's kind of the question you would ask your pet, right?
Well, since I was a little girl, I always wanted a dog. And my parents said no. They're like, no, you can't have one. You're not responsible. I'm like, what are you talking about? I want a dog. They're like, no. They bought me a stuffed dog. I'm like, thanks, guys. That's not what I wanted.
How old were you?
Like 13.
They got
your
stuffed dog?
Yeah. Same. Yeah, exactly. Hopefully my mom's not listening.
It's okay. It was a while ago.
Yeah. So when I turned 18, my son's father's brother came home with a puppy, and I was like, he's mine. I gotta have him. And he's been with me ever since. I couldn't let him go.
Yeah. I love him. I love pets. I love animals. I'm sorry. I do. So, okay, so you've had him since then.
Yeah.
Wow.
And he was a challenge. He was
in the beginning?
Yeah, he was a lot, and I learned a lot from him. He was pretty much an escape artist. I would destroy everything, my shoes, everything. He even destroyed the patio.
You mean, was it wood patio? Like, how did he chew on that?
It was a fence.
Fence?
Yeah. Wow. And he broke out of it with his crazy jaws of his, you know, those pit bulls.
That's true. They do have those crazy.
Hey, guys. Jaws.
Okay, cool. Hey, Steph, what's up?
Hi, I made it.
How was your trip from the airport?
You know what? I'm not at the airport. I actually had to turn around and come back to my girlfriend's house that I'm staying at because the flight was overbooked, so not on my way to Nashville yet, but we're supposed to leave in the morning. But I wanted to interject because I thought it was a great time to say, like, it's crazy. It doesn't matter what our animals do, but we still love them, like, an insane amount.
Yes.
My cat, he can poop on the floor. He can throw up. Like, he can do any number of things. And it's like, oh, honey, it's okay. But if my 15-year-old does something like that, it's a huge problem.
It's so true.
It is. I've gone through it all.
It's true. Yeah.
And now I do it for my clients, so.
It's true. Yeah, we love them regardless. And what I was going to bring up is I think they help us with that unconditional love. They really do because, first they teach us love because some people don't love or don't know and they're closed in, but pets actually help, and especially if you don't have a partner or you know, kids, that you extend that love. Of course, you can love anyone or yourself for the first, you know, that's the main thing. But animals help you to kind of, you know, be able to love and have that kind heart. And that's why we have them. Well, I mean, that's not the only reason, but I think it's important very much.
Oh, yeah.
Learn.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Unconditional love.
And they help
it's
us
so much
connect
easier
with the world.
To love animals than it is to love humans.
Actually, Stephanie, actually, you missed a part where I said that you're the one who says, I mean, I also say that, but you say it's much easier to be around pets than people sometimes.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Actually, most times. They don't have any bad intentions. They totally love you, and well, they love you as long as you feed them really well and clean their litter box.
Yeah, I mean, of course.
But yeah, I mean, definitely, like from our side, I think it totally teaches unconditional love because, again, they can pretty much do anything to you, and you'll still love them.
Mhm. No, it's true. It's true. Yeah. Because you have two of them, right?
I do. And, you know, I'm really actually very sad because since we're moving to California, I'm leaving my babies behind with my cousin. And I know she's going to take really, really good care of them. But I haven't been away from my babies more than, like, 2 weeks at the most in their whole entire life. And it's going to be, like, 6 months we're going to be gone at least before I'll be able to get them back. So, I don't know. It's kind of depressing. I'm really sad. I cried. And they don't know what's going on. It's not like I can tell them, Mom, it's going to be bad. It's going to be okay. It's all going to work out for the best for everyone.
Well, it's hard. It's hard to leave them behind, especially when you have a huge transition like that.
Oh, yeah.
Do you think they'll remember
them? Of course. Yeah. I mean, like... Yes.
Of course they will remember me. I don't know. I don't think 6 months is long enough to forget. They better remember me. He'll be mad for a while. At least, like, for the first month, he's gonna have an attitude and, like, stick his butt in the air and be mean to me. But he'll get over it.
I'm home for 3 days. With Charlie.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
They definitely have their own attitude.
Yes, with age, Charlie's becoming more of like cuddler, and he wants my attention. And so when I'm gone, he gives me even bigger attitude. Like, why?
Or better yet, attitude.
Yes, so I have to hear about all of his complaints for about a full day, and then he's done.
He's like, I told you, Mom.
Seriously, and I literally come home and I ask him, okay, you tell me all right now. Tell me what happened, what your problems are. Just tell me all so you are done when I know you're done and we don't talk about it anymore because I don't want to hear about it. Well, because they can get a little annoying. I mean, after a little while, they meow and meow.
Some of them are needy.
They're needy, just like people.
Exactly. Different personalities.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah,
exactly.
But they're home alone
yeah.
all day long. They just want somebody to talk to, that's all.
And that's why I started my business, so they don't have to be alone all day.
Beautiful. We need you.
We need you.
I know.
I'm like everybody's second mom.
True. No, what a best way to spend your day. Like, it's totally an amazing business, I think.
It is.
You know?
It is.
No wonder you don't stress anymore. She doesn't stress anymore, Stephanie.
You know, if I got to deal with animals all day and know people, I think I'd be pretty happy too.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Okay.
Well,
cool.
And you're dealing with pet parents, and pet parents are usually nicer than non-pet parents.
Oh yes, most definitely. And yeah. Can I add something?
Yeah.
People who have dogs are nicer than people with cats.
Oh really? Yeah.
I'll give you that.
She's bashing us, Stephanie.
I know. I agree.
Like,
I agree. I think
more
people that are cat people are more like cats.
I can see that. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And I read in a book when I was going to school, but then I actually saw it in real life. I was like, oh, wait, it is true.
Yeah. No, I can see that because cat nature is one way, which, yeah, they are more independent and you can say isolated. Mm-hmm. And dogs are like, love me, love me, love me.
All the time.
All the time. So,
especially as puppies.
So, yeah. So that's why, like, I'm still, like, not, because I do want to have a dog eventually. Mm-hmm. I believe, I think I do right now. but I haven't gotten to that point, and I think I am coming up with excuses such as I'm busy and I'm travel, but maybe because it would require me to be more, you know, going and doing, and I'm already going and doing
other things.
Yes. So I think maybe that is pushing me back, and, you know, I'm fine with the cat right now.
Yeah. I mean, they're easier.
They are. They are easier. But you're right. I agree with you. Yeah, people a little bit more isolated with cats than the dogs.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because they're more independent, and they have, you know, their litter box, mm-hmm. and they free feed, and dogs aren't that way.
Yeah, I think the people, owners with dogs, they have to be out.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what pushes them, and personalities too, I guess.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's interesting. So how, what other benefits do specifically dogs and cats give to people? Like what? Because they don't do much. I mean, the only reason, the only benefit that Charlie does besides my health is I don't have rats, or I will not have rats, and I didn't have rats or mice.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever.
They're great for killing spiders.
Yeah. They don't kill them. They don't kill anything. They play with them. At least my cat plays with them. They, you know, he's just enjoying their presence. And
oh, yeah. Mine plays with them to death.
Yeah. To death.
Yes.
Literally.
But, yeah, besides the mice, it's mainly, like, you know, for me, you know, and he's has a luxury life here with food every day, all the time on his plate. But what other benefits do we observe? Like, we talk about stress, which is so important. I think it's main thing, and probably that's why I have the cat. And the heart.
Yes, the heart.
The heart is important. The which contributes, I believe, to immune system. What about what about people with challenges, for example, blind people, deaf, you know, that's amazing what dogs do for them.
Oh, yeah. They're a huge contribution to their lifestyle.
That's just, you know, have you had a contact with that? Have you trained dogs like that?
I haven't trained a dog, a therapeutic dog before, but I did work with a lady that lived in a nursing home, and she had her dog. And I would go and, you know, help him out, take him out. But it was very different for me because usually I have to, you know, be controlled the whole time with, you know, baby dog. Sounds walking down the street.
And he was just so easy. He was, like, totally trained.
You didn't have to do anything.
No,
it's like he was walking you.
Exactly.
Oh, like going for a stroll.
Yeah. Well, it's wonderful. I can't even express how important it is to have to be okay with animals, to have them in your life and be open to them. And sometimes there is a challenge with especially dogs when they're a little bit aggressive.
Mm-hmm.
But like you said, it's people. Well, it's interesting because I have my father has a dog and he's just beautiful with him. You know, they are like, you know, connected. It's for life. I feel like, you know, they're married. But the dog is afraid of other people
because of the way that they react to him.
Ah.
You see, it's energy. So let's say your dad is walking his dog down the street and somebody's, like, coming towards them. And if they have a really bad energy or if they're scared of the dog's going to react to that.
Mm-hmm.
Or if your dad feels threatened or anything by the other person, the dog's going to react to that.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about energy.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's interesting because he's had her for number of years. I can't remember how old she is, maybe 10, something like that. And I believe it's been from the beginning, kind of. And the dog didn't have any, I believe, no problems before when she was little. So it feels like she's always been like that, but it something has to happen or something is happening to create that.
Exactly.
Because I've been in the presence of his dog, and I've been able to get as close to her as anybody else.
Okay.
But I only been there for a short time, so I couldn't have enough time. But because, yes, you are a little bit afraid because mm-hmm. she's already positioned like that.
Exactly.
Right? And I was able to kind of become that more stable, but because of a lot going on and her being, you know, already kind of aggressive, it is a little scary.
Exactly.
So, like, I tried and it worked for a little bit. It did. But with others I observed, it was much more complicated. So it can be interesting, challenging.
Exactly.
Sometimes. But I agree with you. Energy is so important. So important.
And they're really connected to their surroundings and the energies around them. And we lost that. We used to be that way.
Because their senses is so more thin, you know, like exactly. so more sensitive mm-hmm. than ours. And you're right, we did lose that connection. And I mean, we have it.
Yeah.
We're just ignoring it,
exactly.
kind of a thing. You know, you can tune in anytime mm-hmm. to that connection, energy. So, yeah, I observed. Dogs like that too, like, you know, you have to be specific and, you know, balancing it. So yeah, okay, I'll speak to him, maybe I'll kind of can explain a little bit, but
okay,
he probably knows, but I don't know.
Awesome.
Yeah,
awesome.
Yeah.
Well, to go into benefits as well with people with young children, babies, babies that are raised in families with pets are less likely to have allergies and asthma.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
Because you know how usually they say...
yes, I know.
Uh-huh.
They told me that when I used to take my son to the doctor.
Yes,
he's
yes.
a dog. Yes. Oh, you know what? No, it's not happening. And my son is fine.
Wow. So they. How do you know how they contribute to not having asthma or allergy? For example, my niece, she has allergy on cats, for pets.
Mm-hmm.
And... like, she wants to have a cat, I think, so much. But because of that, they don't get, you know, they're
yeah.
not having it. So I wonder how, you know, what can I explain to her to say that I don't think it's possibly an issue. Is it mental? You think
no,
it's mental?
Well, some people are just allergic to certain things. They're born
mm-hmm.
that way,
mm-hmm.
obviously. But when you have a dog or cat that goes outdoors and they come indoors, it's a smaller portion of, like, stuff from the outside.
Right.
So they bring it in, and then the baby, you know, goes and touches them, and they breathe all of the chemicals in and stuff like that, and they just get immune to it.
Interesting. That makes sense. It's kind of like when you allow children to play in dirt.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
they
like
have
that.
To get used to it.
Yeah, immune system gets
exactly.
built up, and they're okay, and when they're older, they're... you know, they're not
going to affect them.
Right, right. Okay, so it's the same concept.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
very, very good.
Yeah.
That's a good benefit for allergy in kids. Anything else you got?
Yes.
And
also, I need to know about, and babies with dogs or cats at home have fewer colds and ear infections during the first year.
Oh, wow. And how's that?
Same thing.
Same thing?
Yeah, same thing.
Wow.
It's a huge benefit, especially for young children, to grow up with them the first year. It's very beneficial for their health because they're exposed to a lot of things.
Well, plus, I mean, health-wise, and plus, they're like babysitters too.
Exactly. My dog babysits my son. I just go sit over there with him.
Yeah, yeah. You can cook, you can do whatever you
yeah,
want.
Yeah,
you can just watch him.
And there's always TV too.
Of course, yes.
Yeah.
Cool, very cool.
Yeah, I mean, TV, yeah, it's even Stephanie with Kai, she has specific things that she shows to him because she's particularly about.
Yeah, yeah, no, I am too. I can completely understand.
Yeah, she has her little movies and videos that she plays for him. Yeah, and it helps, of course. But and actually, cats are very tolerable with kids. Like, I don't know about Charlie because he's spoiled, you know. But hey, one day
my son tried with him though. He tried, but Charlie was like, nope, and he went to go hide. But I was like, oh, that's it. There's no more to it.
Well, but if he's positioned in a situation when there is no choice, he's gonna have to.
Yeah,
you know. So
yeah.
And. Like every one of us. But I've seen Stephanie's cat being very tolerable with Kai, and he literally just grabbed him,
yeah.
Puts him, and he's waiting. He's sitting there. But they've been there since he was born. I mean,
okay.
Even before he was born. So they've been sensing him all this time. So it's not anything out of blue.
Exactly.
Like, it's potentially not like a situation with Charlie. Maybe with him, it would be different.
Yes.
As well, if it's a longer time. So.
And I can actually go into how I trained my dog to get ready for my son. So I have
yeah.
at least 3 or 4 clients that are pregnant,
awesome.
They're expecting,
uh-huh.
And they ask me, what can I do? What can I do? Well, what I did was pretty much I did a bunch of research. And I used to, starting at 6 months before my due date, I started wearing baby lotion and putting sounds of screaming babies. And noises that the baby would make, and on the crib I would leave my phone there, and my dog would be like, "What in the world is that?" Like,
it makes
he
sense.
He just got used to it. He got so used to it that when I brought my son home, it was like he was already there.
Because he's over, yeah. He's kind of like senses and
exactly.
noses that he's
mm-hmm.
already present. That's actually very good.
And it was
yeah.
funny because my dog, he would sleep under the bed where I would sleep. And every time I would wake up, he would follow me wherever I go. He was, like, so overprotective over me.
Yeah.
He would let nobody get near me. No one. I could, like, be walking in the park, and someone would try to pet him. No, he was like, no, you're not getting near us.
So he already was protecting you
yes.
and the baby.
Yes.
Yeah.
And before that, he didn't care.
Wow.
He was more like, ooh, love me. And then after that, when I was huge, he was like, get away from us. He would growl. And he would never, like, before that, he would never do that. Yeah. Never.
He positioned himself as a protector
exactly.
you know, in the role,
mm-hmm.
and yeah, and that's another benefit. Here we go,
yeah.
especially
yeah.
as a single mom.
Exactly.
You know, you gotta go. You've got that protector.
Yeah.
I don't need a
boyfriend.
Hey.
I don't need an alarm system. Honestly.
Oh yeah. I agree with
I
you.
I know when somebody's in my driveway all the time, and it's funny because I don't know if other people have this too, but I know exactly who's coming to my house. Because of my dog, the way that he barks and the way that he acts.
Different barking times.
And I don't know if my little cousin is listening, but every time he comes to my house, he sounds like a turkey. Like, oh, Laura's here. I love it. Yeah, and if it's a stranger, he sounds pretty pissed off.
So you can
yeah.
recognize
yeah.
him, by the way.
I'm like, oh,
who
yeah.
is that?
Yo.
I don't know you.
Yeah.
yeah. That's nice. See, you eliminated the
alarm
system, the boyfriend, the doctor. What else can we eliminate? You know, of course, we're kidding about it, but yes,
yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
part of it is the truth. You know,
mm-hmm.
they do serve as those
yeah.
Other things that you need to have in life, but you don't need to anymore.
And also, I had a doorman. So what happened was, after I had my son, you know, when you have a kid, a newborn, you always have them in the car seat.
Right.
So I would carry him in the house. I'm like, hey, go close the door. He'll go over and close the door for me behind me so nobody could get in behind me. I trained him to do that when I was pregnant, too.
Oh, my God.
Wow. See, you can contribute to clients like that, too. You can train him to do this kind of stuff.
You know how many times I wish Charlie could make coffee for me in the morning?
Oh, my God, yes. You know what I mean? Like, Charlie, can you?
Do
one
thing for me.
101 Dalmatians.
Yes.
Oh my God. I want to do that.
I know.
But I'm not at that level.
Could you please? And if you figure out how you can train my kids to make coffee in the morning,
I will pay you. I'm pretty sure if you teach them how to press a button, that's it. Like,
if you set it up and
yeah.
he pushes it,
yeah.
and then
it's
done. Yeah, he's tall enough for this. I think he could. Well, anyway, let's very quickly go to one more commercial break, and we will be back.
Are you sick of being a chump, lied to by politicians and businessmen alike, watching as the world slowly burns, as trillions of debts racked up under your grandchildren's names? Hi, I'm Ben Lucifer Bernanke Cochran. I'm asking that you tune into my weekly radio show, The Patriot Power Hour with Lucifer Bernanke, each Thursday night at 6 p.m. Eastern on Freedomizer Radio. Look, I'm not trying to sell you anything here. I just need your help fighting these banks of scum. The sycophants, behind all the wars, failed healthcare system, I mean, they own all the mega banks, all the mega corporations. They own the media, of course. They've already conquered most of humanity, really. And their juiciest, final target. Well, we're next. America's next. So I'm not going out without a fight. So join me Thursday as I use my background in finance and risk management to decode breaking news and developments, all while helping to prepare you and your family for the future waves of financial terrorism that are sure to come. Thursday night, 6 p.m. Eastern, only on FreedomizerRadio.com.
There are a lot of problems with Common Core. I don't even have time to go into most of them. But a step in the right direction would be to give local communities, teachers, parents control over their schools so they can design curriculums and standards to best meet the needs of their students and get the federal government out of education.
Aloha, this is Katmir Stone of Freedomizer Radio. I was born and raised in the Caribbean tropical coast and enjoyed living along the Blue Ridge Mountains of Appalachia, both places where Mother Nature rules and shoes are optional. Now living in the ninth largest metropolitan area in the United States, I'm surprised that more people don't realize that their health would improve if they just took off their shoes and relaxed. Yes, even in the middle of downtown. Bunions, hammer toes, atrophied pinkies, fungus issues, weak structure, all these foot problems caused by shoes are simply due to the fact that people don't know that being barefoot is not just the natural, comfortable solution, it's legal. That's right, Freedomizers. We at barefootislegal.org host a weekly radio show where we discuss the many health benefits and zero laws concerning going barefoot. Join Nicola, Kiliki Claybaugh, Patty Peaceful, and yours truly, Katmir Stone, every Saturday starting at 10:30 a.m. Pacific, 1:30 p.m. Eastern for Barefoot is Legal Radio. Hashtag Freedomizer Radio. Hashtag Shoes Ruined My Feet. Hashtag Barefoot is Legal.org.
Please learn more about Freedomizer Radio by going to FreedomizerRadio.com and also Facebook us right at FreedomizerRadio.com. Catch you there.
Hello, we are back on the radio. We are here in studio with Dee at Romes Paws. I'm very excited she's here with us today because she is an owner of her business, pet sitting business. I have connected with her and very happy that she can watch after my little pumpkin. But I definitely would love to kind of pick her brain a little more about her services and what she does and what she can do for our pets and her specialties. And we can just go into that for a little bit more.
All right.
Yep.
So pretty much my services are dog walking, pet sitting, dogs and cats, and I also do vet tech stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Depends on the situation. If it's like I have to go there and do IV fluids, I can do it, but I would need somebody to help, like the owner.
Right.
So mm-hmm. if any emergency were to come up while I'm working, I know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have to, you know, take that extra trip to the hospital.
Oh, that's amazing. I mean, that's a big plus because the clients feel more comfortable.
Yes.
You know, if anything, at least you know how to react.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Not freaking out, not, you know, between the pet and now you know how to be with the pet. So,
yeah.
That's very, very good. So do you typically, right now, do you more concentrate on dogs and cats or
Like what specific services? For example, do you just walk dogs? Do you take them in sometimes? Do you, like, anything specific you do with them? Like,
right now, I'm pretty much midday. I'm booked every day. It's dog walking. I just go in my client's house, go out, walk the dog, and go back, and it's all crazy. I love it. But, like, and I feel like I start at 11:30, and I finish, like, around 3 in the afternoon. And then I do my pet sitting services for cats and dogs that when people go on vacation or business trips, I'm there. I'm early in the morning and late in the afternoon.
Cuddling.
Yes, exactly. I feed them, and if they need to walk with their dog, I take them on a walk, interact with them so they don't feel lonely, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And for that, most of the time, I do take my son, and that's a big plus for me, and he gets to, you know, interact with them too.
It's fun for him as well.
Yes, exactly.
He goes to places. And it's true, you do get to go to different places.
Yes.
Fun. You know, it's funny because when I travel, and I love traveling, especially abroad, it's my little secret. I like to peek into windows. And not because people probably think I'm, you know,
yeah.
stalking them.
Yeah.
But because my line of work is in design.
Gotcha.
I love kind of like seeing how the apartment's set up and, like, imagine what they do, especially if it's a different country because
yeah.
you're curious how
exactly.
people live somewhere else.
Yeah.
So I always try to kind of, like, peek into the windows because it's just fun.
Yeah.
You know,
I get it.
I don't want to see you naked, but, hey, I mean,
I get to do that when I go meet the clients. I'm like, oh, okay.
You get an
nice.
Idea.
Yeah, and then, like, I move my stuff around at home, like, this could go over here. They have that plant. It looks cute. Like, let me get that too. Like, you know?
No, I totally, I understand. I do the same thing too.
We get to pick other people's brains without them knowing it.
Exactly. And I mean, and it's funny. No, actually, it's amazing because when I was on vacation and you were here watching after Charlie,
mm-hmm.
you sent pictures.
Yes.
So it's kind of like a confirmation for me. It was, okay, he's alive, he's happy.
Not only that, but you knew I was actually here.
Yes.
Very true. And I do it pretty much live.
Very
so I walk in, make sure everything's okay. I get, you know, food out and whatnot, interact with them. And sometimes I send, if it's to your phone, I can send videos.
Mm-hmm.
If it's through email, I can't really do a video, but I do send pictures.
Mm-hmm.
I love doing that, and all my clients love it.
I think it's a great contribution to the service. Yeah, absolutely. also, like, how do you, like, in the beginning, how do you approach? Do you evaluate? Do you come and, like, for me, you came and we talked. Is that kind of like a standard procedure?
Standard procedure would be obviously talking through the phone, how, you know, to raise and whatnot, if that's okay with the client. And then we set up the meet and greet where I get to meet the client, see if it's going to work out.
Check out their energy.
Exactly. No, honestly, I do. I'm not going to lie.
What am I into here, right? Like, how do I have to prepare myself
exactly.
for this service?
Yeah. Exactly. And not only that, but for the pet to get to know me and see if that's going to work out with them too.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Well,
sometimes it doesn't work out and you can't really do much about it. You just let them know, oh, not really going to work out, but that's pretty much standard procedure.
Yeah.
Do the meet and greet and see where it goes from there.
Mm-hmm. No, that's very good. Very good. So, and where are your services in regard to locations? Where do you expand your services in this area?
So, right now I'm serving Hydesville, Silver Spring, and pretty much most of D.C.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because I do live in Hydesville.
Mm-hmm.
So I have to drive back and forth from there every day.
Hey.
Don't we all?
Yeah.
One way or the other.
Either way, it is down the street, but it's like an all-day thing.
Uh-huh.
So I begin my day in D.C., go back home, hang out with my dog for a while, and then I go back to D.C. for midday and then come back to Tacoma Park. Also, I serve Tacoma Park because it's down the street from my house. And then from there, I go home. And then my afternoon shift, which is for pet sitting, is sometimes. Sometimes I have nothing for the afternoon.
Beautiful.
But I'm everywhere all day.
Do you have kind of a time? I'm sure it depends on
mm-hmm.
your schedule, but do people need to give you some sort of, like, for example, if I'm leaving on vacation or work,
how in advance do you prefer to receive the notice?
At least 3 to 4 days. If it's an emergency, like, I'll just put it in, and I let them know, like, if you need me to come in at 9 a.m., I can't make it. Mm-hmm. I'll be there, like, around 10.
Right. Well, I don't think people really, like, from my experience, I don't think it really matters time-wise, at least for cats.
Yeah.
Dogs,
yeah.
Yes, you have to go and walk.
Exactly.
It's different ball.
Exactly.
For cats, you know.
Exactly.
It's usually,
and it depends on the client, too, I thought, you know.
I'm pretty sure, you know, some clients are a little bit more strict with their schedule, but in reality, cats can survive and they're okay. It doesn't matter. Okay, so you need to, you know, maybe 3-4 days if possible.
Yes.
Okay, very good. Just trying to think, what else would I want to know from you?
Well, as far as for pet sitting, like cats and dogs, and I do bunnies as well.
Aww.
I take care of them if they need administration of medication.
Mm-hmm.
So I can do that too.
Anyone have bunnies?
Oh my gosh.
People have bunnies.
Yes, they do. I went to go take care of a bunny last December, and he needed a lot of care.
Really?
Medication, take down notes about how he's doing and whatnot. He was a pretty sick bunny, but he did great.
He did good.
Yeah, he did. And I also administer medication for cats. Some people don't do it. And I don't charge a lot more. Some people, like some big companies, they charge like $15 to $20 just for medication, and I don't do that much.
Mm-hmm.
I don't do it. I'm like, you know what? I know how to do it. It's fine.
Yeah, medication is something else, I guess we could, you know, maybe we could talk next time if we bring you in. Like, for example, my cat doesn't have any issues, so I've kept him very much natural.
Yes.
You know, and he's 11, and yes, he could lose a good couple of pounds for sure, but overall, he's never had issues.
That's great.
And I mean, maybe potentially he was just from a healthy mom. But, and I'm, you know, I will even say it on the radio, I don't give him shots. I mean, I understand the reason.
Yes.
But from my experience, I've only experienced the positive side of it.
Mm-hmm.
And he's only inside cat.
Yes.
And
I could add to that, actually.
Yeah.
When I was working at Animal Hospital, there were some people that would just go and just see if the cat was okay, no shots or anything. And the thing was, they're indoor cats. They're indoor cats, and they don't really need much. They're not exposed to things outside that can get them sick,
yeah,
stuff like that. So I completely understand where you're coming from.
I mean, my cat, and one reason I don't like to take him to the vet is because it's always a chore. I mean, it's not necessarily doing it, it's putting him through stress, especially him, because he doesn't like it.
Yeah.
And it's just painful. You know,
it's work. Like, just get him in the car. I know, I've done it
before. Physically, I mean, one thing, fine. You do it physically, fine. I already know how to do it. I found my way, and it works, and it's fine. You actually take him down.
Yes.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
You got it.
Yeah, I can't remember who told me that. I think it was one of my friends. I was one time so frustrated and even got to the point of crying because you're helpless.
Exactly.
He's in the corner running away from you. You can't get him. So when I finally learned that method, and it works every time. But I know he's stressed and I feel it, and I try, like we're talking about energy, I always try to stay neutral and calm. But it's sometimes also a challenge because I know.
Because he's the one challenging you.
Yes.
That's the thing. And it stresses you out and he feels it.
See? Yes.
Energy.
I know. So one reason I, you know, don't do any of that is because of that. And I think, you know, stressing him out is, you know, it's also damaging his health and mine.
Exactly.
So unless he needs it, you know, and that would be
another story.
That's another story, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, all the vaccination, you know, sometimes it's better to be without it. But, I mean, it's just personal experience for me. I don't do any vaccines on myself, like flu shots and all of that. I don't do. So
I don't do it either. You okay?
Yeah. I mean, people get sick more from it.
Exactly. I tried it because my doctor told me I needed to do it after I had my son. I was like, okay, whatever. I went and I felt like, I don't know
what. You were sick.
I was horrible. My arm hurt. I was like, I'm not doing this ever again. This is horrible. I don't know why people do it every year.
Because people tell them to do. Because we, another point, take responsibility for your health.
Mm-hmm.
If someone is telling you this is going to help your health, don't take it for
it's
just
your
their
decision.
Words.
Yes. It's your decision.
Make do research. What is in those pills? You know, what is in that shot? Because they are not responsible. You know, if you'll die, they don't care. It was your choice to take a shot. So be mindful.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and the same with that. Be mindful, like
about your children.
Exactly. Like, you know, they are your children.
Exactly.
And sometimes you do put a lot of money into giving them care, and that's the thing. I've seen people putting them through surgeries and putting so much money into it, and then at the same time, all the medications that they did before and vaccines, I'm like, what are you feeding them? All of those things. So preventive measures.
Exactly.
Instead of
mm-hmm.
reactive measures. So anyway, I think we're getting closer to the end. We typically give out, actually every week, we give out homework for our audience to do. And this time, since we're talking about pets, I thought, and maybe you can contribute to this
okay.
and say this is a good homework to do, but what I was thinking is if you have a pet and, you know, you've had them for a while and you know him, her, you know, I guess everyone knows that it helps you health-wise, but do an experiment, and maybe if you are away, like you're traveling or you're staying with somebody else or you're not home, you're not seeing the pet, you know, observe how you feel at the end of the day. Like literally just be mindful of it and literally just make that exercise, you know, and see, how do you feel? And then take notes and see how you feel. Describe your feelings so you remember when you do it when you are home, and do like maybe 3 days in a row and see how you feel. So I think I'm curious if you are mindful and you do this exercise, what will come out of it? Because we know it releases stress, but maybe it will even benefit your issues, like
mm-hmm.
health issues that you're having now.
Mental issues.
In mental issues. That well, that's
emotional
what,
issues.
That's what creates the physical issues.
Yeah.
So, I mean, majority of time.
Mm-hmm.
So I was thinking that, just do an experiment, compare how you feel without the pet or with pet. Or if you don't have a pet, you know, try to go to a pet store after work and be with, just even being with animals around you.
And you can actually ask the people in there if you can actually pet the dog for at least 5 minutes and see how you feel.
Exactly. Like, especially if you haven't had pets and if you don't have pets, do that experiment and see it. And then make a decision. Maybe you should get a pet. You know, if your health is important to you, why not? Of course, be mindful that it is a responsibility.
Very big.
Yes, and you will have to feed cat, dog. You have to walk. You have to put, you know, finances into that. It all comes with, you know, you have to do things. But the benefit is big. And I observe it in my life. I'm so happy I have my Charlie. In however form he comes, he's still mine, and he still helps me with everything that I'm going through when I need to, especially. So, yeah, I thought that was the homework. What do you think?
It's awesome.
Yeah,
love it.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. So, okay, so please, what I want to do last is just, you know, give more information to our guests about Dee. Can you tell your, you know, all the contact information that you have that our listeners can use if they choose to, you know, ask you questions or come to you for service, anything they, you know, they want to present when you leave
the air.
Yeah. So please tell us your information, your Facebook, your website, everything.
All right, so my website is www.romespaws.com.
Can you spell that?
R-O-M-E-S-P-A-W-S.
Okay, cool.
And also you can find me on Facebook at Romes Paws. Spell the same. And you could always call or text me at 301-640-9503. That's my cell phone. You can always leave a message. I am always busy during the midday. You'll get that. But leave a message, and I'll get back to you whenever I can.
Awesome. Very cool. Very cool. So, and I will give out my information. If you want to reach me, you can go to www.oxanaganchar.com. It's one word, OXANAGONCHAR. Or you can email me as well at mindbodyandsoul. It's all one word and spelled out at OxanaGanchar.com. Also, Stephanie is not with us right now, so I will remind you her information. You can reach her at www.edensbalance.com. It's EDENSBALANSE. Or email her at Stephanie, STEPHANIE, at EdensBalance.com. Or you can find us on Facebook. Our Facebook page is www.facebook.com/Body and Soul Awareness Radio. So we are going to finish this week's radio show, and we will be seeing you next Sunday at 6 p.m. Eastern Time. Please do have a wonderful week, and enjoy the last piece of our show, and we will chat with you next week. Have a good night.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata. Ain't no passing craze. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's our poetry.
Hakuna Matata.
Hakuna Matata?
Yeah, it's our motto.
What's the motto?
Nothing. What's the motto with you? You know, these two words will solve all your problems.
That's right. Take Pumbaa, for example. Why, when he was a young warthog.
When I was a young warthog.
Very nice. He found his aroma like a certain appeal. He could clear the savanna after every meal.
I was under the soul, though I seemed thick skin. And it hurt, but my friends never stood down the wind. Oh, the shame!
What a shame!
What a shame in my name!
Oh, what a name!
I got downhearted
on the field
every time I... Hakuna Matata, what a wonderful phrase. Hakuna Matata, ain't no passing craze.
It means no worries for the rest of your days.
Yeah, see it, see it.
It's our cup of tea. It wants to be Hakuna Matata.
Welcome to our humble home.
You live here?
We live wherever we want.
Yep, home is where your rump rests.
It's beautiful.
Stop.
I'm so hungry I could eat a whole zebra.
We're fresh out of zebra.
Any antelope?
Nah.
Hippo?
Nope. Listen, kid, if you live with us, you have to eat like us. Hey, this looks like a good spot to rustle up some grub.
Ew, what's that?
A grub. What's it look like?
Ew, grub.
Tastes like chicken.
It's slimy yet satisfying.
These are rare delicacies. Pecan with a very cutting crunch.
You're learning to love them.
I'm telling you, Ted, this is the great life. No rules, no responsibilities. Ooh, the little cream filled kind. And best of all, no worry. Well, kiss.
Oh, well. Hakuna Matata. Funny and satisfying.
That's
it. It means no worry for the rest of your day. It's all problem free. Hakuna Matata. Hakuna Matata. Yeah.